Bharat Kumar from Neptune Marine Info, where knowledge has no boundaries. So friends, from today, I am going to share with you some details about the marine diesel engine. So without a wasting of time, let's start our topic. In today's session, we are going to cover this contents: concept of internal combustion engine, classification of IC engine, advantages and disadvantages of diesel engine. So friends, till the end of this session, connect with me and know about the marine diesel engine. Concept of internal combustion engine. So friends, why it is called internal combustion engine? Because the combustion takes place inside the combustion chamber. That's why it is called internal combustion engine. A marine diesel engines are basically reciprocating engines using heavy fuel oil or diesel oil in a compression ignition system. A compression ignition system uses a heat from compression to ignite the fuel in the combustion chamber. Fuel upon ignition, the combustion chamber gives a combustion force which pushes down the piston. So work is done in the cylinder by combustive gases. This reciprocating motion of the piston due to the combustive gas forces is transformed into rotary motion of the crankshaft. This is done by means of connecting rod and crank mechanism. So friends, let's discuss about the classification of internal combustion engine. First one is two-stroke or four-stroke. Usually, two-stroke is preferred for marine engine propulsion and four-stroke is preferred for auxiliary diesel generation. Now, second one is fuel used. Petroleum fuel like a gasoline, naphtha, kerosene, gas oil, diesel oil. Heavy fuel like a motor oil, burner fuel. Residual fuels, gaseous fuels and mixed fuel for starting combustion and gaseous fuel for running. Now friends, third one is a single acting or double acting. A single acting engine is one where the upper part of the cylinder is used for combustion, where a double acting engine is one which uses both upper and lower part of the cylinder alternatively. Now fourth one is supercharged. In a supercharged engines, air under pressure is supplied to the cylinder, which is pressurized externally by mechanical means or exhaust blower. Now, fifth one is compression ignition engine or spark ignition engine. If we are talking about a compression ignition, the fuel ignites with the air due to high temperature caused by the compression of air. In a spark ignition, an external electric spark is used for ignition. Now friends, sixth one is a trunk type engines or crosshead engines. In a trunk type engines, the piston has an extended skirt which act as a guide. In a crosshead engines, there is a crosshead which has shoes sliding over the crosshead guides. Friends, seventh one is a single and multi-cylinder engine. Modern marine engines uses 4 to 12 cylinders. Eighth one, W, V or X pattern of arrangement of the cylinders. Ninth one, main propulsion use or auxiliary engine use. Tenth one is low, medium and high speed, where low speed is 100 to 350 rpm, medium speed 350 to 750 rpm and high speed is 750 to 2500 rpm. Now 11th, mean piston speed, where low speed is 4.5 meter per second to 7 meter per second, medium speed 7 to 10 meter per second and high speed is 10 to 15 meter per second. Now, 12th, unidirectional or reversible engine using a reversing mechanism. 13th, a head direction in a clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. Now friends, let's see some advantages of diesel engine. First one is a high efficiency and recovery of waste heat. Then increased maneuvering abilities, highest use of heat generated during combustion. Fourth one is increased time period before refueling. Fifth one is increased standby reliability. Last but not the least, increased cargo carrying capacity. Friends, let's see disadvantages of diesel engine. First one is high capital cost, complicated design and construction. Second one is a high lube oil cost in medium and high speed engine. Third one is a high inertia loads due to reciprocating and rotating masses. Pressures and temperatures are always varying in the system. High idling speed of crankshaft and irregular rotation. So friends, this is nothing but the advantages and disadvantages of the diesel engine. Friends, I just finished this session here and we will familiarize with parts of marine diesel engine in upcoming video session. Till, keep learning, keep growing.